Yesterday I told you about the activity. So I'm giving you 1 week time. By next Monday, you all can submit. Above all, many of you all are going to write Hindi exam now. So I'm giving you time. So by next Monday, you all can submit the activity. Okay. And then yesterday we finished. We are halfway through the lesson. So we'll start from the topic. Which lesson? One minute more. I'll take the lesson. Water. Yeah, here. That is characteristics of urban settlements. We finished types of urban settlements. We finished, and yesterday I was talking you about talking to you all about page number 172. Correct, 173. That is how rural and urban areas are interdependent on each other. So first I'll tell you about that. So we know that whatever things which are produced in the villages, for example, take paddy, wheat, any type of grains, it might be vegetables, fruits, all these are brought to the towns and cities. Okay, and it is sold in the supermarket, in many markets. So we people in the town in and cities are buying all these products, and in turn, for example, yesterday if I told you how we are getting the milk from the milkman, so all these in one or any other way, we are dependent on the villages for our daily survival. Okay, likewise, in towns, the village people are also dependent on the towns and villages, because towns and cities. So take the people who are living in the villages, they might not get all the facilities that are available in towns and cities. For example, take schools, then hospitals, colleges, transport facilities. So many things, many shopping malls, all these are not available in the villages. But these people from the villages, they come to the towns and cities to get all these extra things. Yes or no? So this shows how people are interdependent on each other. That is, the village people are dependent on towns and cities, and towns and cities are dependent on villages for everything. Understood? So this shows the interdependent on the rural and the urban areas. And next we are going to see about the next topic. It is a familiar topic and easy one, that is transport. Can we start? I don't want any person to chat. After the end of the session, surely I will ask questions. Okay, is my voice clear? Okay, so now I'll start with the transport. Okay, Jean ma'am, I want to share. No, Jean ma'am, Jennifer ma'am, I want to share the slide. So today we have to start with today we are going to start with transport. So we know that we people are making use of a transport for moving from one place to another. So not only in the movement of the people, but also in the transportation of goods and services. As we people are using different means of transport for moving from one place to another, it links people as well as places. That is, from one place. For example, take today we are going to Chennai. So from Trichy, we are going to Chennai through the transport. Through the, it might be through bus or car or any vehicle it might be. So you can see the link between the people and the places, which leads to the spread of culture and ideas. So what do you mean by the word culture? So in Tamil, we used to say it as kalacharam. Yes or no? That is the ideas, customs and social behavior of the particular people or the city. So that is called as culture. So for example, if your father is getting a transfer to Bombay, okay, this is I'm telling for example. So what will be your way of living? Do you think it will be the same as you followed in Trichy? No. Slowly you will change according to the culture. Slowly you start learning Hindi. Yes or no? As Hindi is a commonly spoken language in Bombay. And then your way of dressing also will change. Food habits. Yes or no? Do you think the same idli and dosa and sambar you will get there in Bombay? No, it will be entirely different. You will get roti. Yes or no? Then chapati, puri, naan. Like that you will change. Yes or no? So like that, slowly you will adapt to the environment. Then the food habit will be changing. Then everything, finally you will change like a ultra modern person. Isn't it? Yes or no? So this shows how we are adapting to the environment according to the changes in the environment. And next, take the period, that is what early human beings were doing when there were no vehicles. What they were doing? So early humans were covering large distance by walking miles and miles. They carried the loads by themselves. Later, they used the animals to carry the loads. After the invention of the wheel, they made bullock cart. Yes or no? So for moving from one place to another. So they also used in the transportation of goods from one place to another. So slowly people started inventing steam and internal combustion engines, which made transportation of the people, goods and services easy. And it was very, very efficient. So it was easy for the, not only for the people to move from one place to another, even the goods and services also moved very efficiently by making use of the steam and internal combustion engines. Then we know that scientific and technical knowledge in the field of transport is going on developing. Now, what is at the progress level? What do you mean by progress? Progress means growth. It led to the development of new forms of transport. So before and all, we saw only bullock carts. We were making use of the animals to pull the cart. But later what happened? Two wheelers were introduced. Then slowly four wheelers. So more number of four wheelers came into existence. Yes or no? Then now before and all, only the people who are wealthy, they went in the flight. But nowadays we can see more number of middle class, that is people who are belonging to middle class families are going in flight. So you can see the growth, the progress, how it has been developed from the olden period to the modern period. So more number of, that is new forms of transport has been developed as we compare it with the olden days to the modern days. So for developing country like India, chief and efficient means of transport is developed such that this development in transportation leads to the formation of link between the consumption and production areas. For example, take that is any raw material. It might be produced in any place, take in any part of the village. And these raw materials, as it is turned into the finished products, it is taken to the place where it is consumed. Okay. For example, these finished products, take a cotton. Now cotton is taken. It is a raw material. It is taken to the place where it is going to be manufactured. Okay. And as it is turned into the finished product, that is dress materials. Now it is taken to the towns and cities where you can see more number of shopping malls. Like Saradas, then Pothys, Chennai Silks. So it is taken to the place where it has been consumed by the people, where people are making use of it, where it is sold. Okay. So for all these things, transportation plays an important role. So this transportation helps in the redistribution of goods and services. So that is what I told you. For example, raw materials like take silk. So these are made into silk sari or any silk material. So these silk saris are brought to the places where it is get sold. So likewise, not only the silk, but other items like cooking ingredients. For example, take Shakti masala or Achi masala powder. So all these powders are turned into finished products. Then it is taken to the from the manufactured place, it is taken to the other place, that is where it has been sold, that is to many shops and different shopping malls. So these products have to be transported from one place to another through the vehicles. So it shows the links between the consumption and the production areas. It links the people from different parts of the country together and keeps them united. Understood? And next we are going to see about the factors that are affecting the development and the type of transportation used in that area. So what are they? What are the factors? That is geographical condition of an area, that is economic activities of a region, scientific and technological development, and population density of an area. So all these are the factors that are affecting the development and the type of transportation used in that area. So now we'll see about that in detail. First, I'll tell you about the geographical conditions of an area. I think most of y'all have gone to Kodaikanal or Ooty, Yerkad, hilly areas. So do you think that moving in the vehicle to these hilly regions are easy? No, it is difficult. So what about the roads? What do you think about the roads and the railway tracks built in these areas like Kodaikanal and Ooty? In Kodaikanal, you don't have that railway track and all. But in Ooty, you'd have seen. Many of y'all have gone in that Ooty train. Yes or no? So in Ooty, you have the roadways till the top. But railways, you have only at the top. So I don't know how many of y'all have gone in that train in Ooty. It goes very slowly. If you have gone, you would have noticed it. It goes very slowly. Since the region is very, very steep, the train moves very slowly to reach the another stop, isn't it? So it shows how dangerous and complicated the roads and the railway tracks are in the hill stations. It is not easy to construct the roads and the railway tracks on the hilly regions. So the Nilgiri Mountain Railway, so is 1,000 millimeter, that is a meter gauge railway in Tamil Nadu. So it was built by British in the year 1908. So the railway is operated by the Southern Railway and is the only railway track, only rack railway in India. So what do you mean by rack railway? So in Tamil you would have heard, that is pallu maari irukku. It used to catch that. அப்படியே அந்த பல்லு மாதிரி அப்படியே பிடிச்சு 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 தான் அப்படியே அந்த தண்டவாளத்தில் ஏறும். யூ ஹவ் சீன், யூ ஹவ் நோட்டிஸ்ட். ஸோ தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் ராக் ரயில்வே. ஸோ இன் ஆர்டர் டு கிளைம் த ஹில்ஸ், தீஸ் ரயில்வேஸ், தீஸ் ட்ராக்ஸ் ஆர் பில்ட் இன் சச் அ வே இட் வில் கேட்ச் தட் டூத் லைக் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் அண்ட் இட் வில் மூவ், இட் வில் டேக் த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டெப். அண்டர்ஸ்டுட்? ஸோ தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ், இட் இஸ் அ ஸ்டீப் கிரேட் ரயில்வே வித் அ டூத் rack rail, usually between the running rails. So this allows the trains to operate on steep grades about 10%, which is the maximum for the friction based rail. So constructing the roads and railway tracks in the mountain regions, deserts and forested areas are not an easy one. So I hope you would have understood this. Now take plains, that is the place we are living in. So we have X number of trains. If you go to Trichy, that is a railway station, you can see more number of trains. People are moving easily from one place to another. So that is why, understand, if you take Ooty or Kodaikanal or Yerkad, that is hilly regions, and when you compare it with the plains, you can notice in hilly regions, you don't have any trains, except that is in Ooty, you have only one train, that is only on the top of the hill. But in case of plains, you have X number of trains, more number of buses, more number of vehicles, because it is very, very easy to construct the roads and the railway tracks in the plains. So more number of people not only the people, even the goods are transported from one place to another very, very easily. So this is the difference between that, how the roads are constructed in the hilly regions as well as the roads and the railway tracks constructed in the plains. Understood? It is not easy to construct the roads and the railway tracks in the mountain region, but it is very, very easy to construct the roads and the railways in the railway tracks in the plains, like Trichy, Chennai, like that. And next is, next topic is economic activities of a region. Now take the raw materials. Raw materials are taken to the place where it is turned into finished products or goods. So once again, these finished products are transported from one place to another place where it gets sold or consumed by the people. So all these are done for what purpose? In order to make money. So agricultural and industrial areas have good transportation network in the movement of goods and services from one place to another. And next topic we are going to see about the scientific and technological development, that is based on the advancement of technology. So first we finished geographical conditions of an area, next one is economic activities of a region, and next is scientific and technological development. So based on the advancement of technology, more number of vehicles have been produced with high speed and efficiency. That is, for example, take, before and all you would have seen your what type of vehicle, two-wheeler, your father was using. Take Hero Honda, Splenda, yes or no? But now you can see the changes. Now most of the people are using Royal Enfield, Bullets, yes or no? It shows the difference. So more number of vehicles, two-wheelers, not only the two-wheelers, take four-wheelers, car. Before and all, Audi was not there. But now you can see Audi. Yes or no? So this shows the change, the transition from the olden age to the modern period. So more number of vehicles have been produced with the high speed and efficiency. So which are very, very useful in the transportation of goods and services, which leads to the formation of the modern transportation. And next is population density of an area. As the population increases in number, there is a need in good network of transportation, which facilitates the movement of goods as well as the people. So as the population is going on increasing, what will happen? So we need good network of transportation. So people are making use of the transport, not only for the movement of the people from one place to another place, but also in the movement of the goods and the services. So as the population is going on increasing, more number of vehicles are also being introduced. So we need that. For example, take during the Diwali or festival time, during the Diwali time or the Pongal time, what will happen? You can see more number of vehicles have been introduced by the government, such that there should be no problems arising in the transportation of people from one place to another place. So more number of vehicles have been introduced by the government during that period of time, during the festival season. Yes or no? You would have seen in Mannarpuram, more number of vehicles are used by the people. Yes or no? You would have noticed in order to avoid confusion. So as the population increases, what will happen? We also need good network of transportation, such that it helps the people, not only the people, even the goods to move from one place to another place. And next we are going to see about the different modes of transport. So what are they? Land transport, water transport, then air transport. So in the, I think so from first standard, you all are learning about this. So first we'll see about the land transport. So in this land transport, we have both the roadways and the railways. So road and rail transport are developed only after the invention of the steam and the internal combustion engines. In which century? In the 18th century and the early 19th centuries. First, I'll tell you about the road transport. Road transport means transportation of goods and person, that is people, from one place to the other on roads. So what do you mean by road? It is a route. For example, if anyone on the road, if you are standing on the road, if any one of you, any of the person is coming and asking you, I have to go to Chennai, or I have to, I want to go to this particular place. Can you tell me the address? Can you tell me the route? So it is a pathway. It is a route between two destinations. That is between the two places. Yes or no? So a road means it is a route or way on land between two places that has been paved, or otherwise it has been improved to allow to travel by foot or by some form of vehicles. Take motor vehicle, it can be either by cart, bullock cart, or bicycle, or the carts used by the cows, horses, or bullocks, like that. Or a two-wheeler, it might be cycle, or scooter or scooty, any vehicle it can be, or four vehicles. So all these will come under the road transport. So what do you mean by road? It is a route between two destinations or two places. It is a way on land between two places. Okay, so more number of vehicles are used. It can be either two-wheeler like cycle, or bike, or carts. It can be used by cows, horses, or bullocks, or four-wheelers like cows. Four-wheelers like cars, then lorries like that, van. So not only people, even the goods are being transported from one place to another place. So roads are of two types. What are they? Metal roads and unmetal roads. In your textbook, they didn't give the brief explanation about the metal and unmetal roads, but I'll tell you what metal roads and unmetal roads. Okay, so metal roads are made up of concrete, cement. Here, as you all can see here, it is made up of concrete, cement. Whereas unmetal roads are made up of mud, not by concrete, cement. Here you can see. So obviously you can find out. All these roads, mud roads are found in the villages, and these type of roads, metal roads, are found in the towns and cities. So roads are used all over the year. That is, we can say that is perennial. On the other hand, unmetal road cannot be used annually. So what is the difference? Metal roads can be used all the year, but unmetal roads cannot be used by the people, because think of the rainy season. If it is raining, what will happen? Can you all make use of these roads? It might lead to any accident. Even the metal roads are dangerous now. Yes or no? Because more number of accidents are occurring. In the olden days and all, government was laying good metal roads. But nowadays, for namesake, within hours, they are laying the metal roads. And within minutes, we can see people traveling, people moving on that road. And after the rain, we can see more, you can see more number of pits. Kundunguliyuma irukku. And automatically, what is happening? Many people are dying because of the accident, road accident. Yes or no? Or losing the life. So now we are going to see about the advantages of the roadways. So making use of the roadways, people and goods are transported from one place to another. So that is the main advantage of the roadways. So by making use of the roadways, people, not only the people, even the goods are transported from one place to another. Okay, and next one, for example, that is for medium and short distances, we are making use of the road transport. So in case of plains, it is easy to build the roads, but it takes hilly regions. Do you think it is very easy to build the roads or the railway tracks? No, it is not easy. But in case of plains, it is very, very easy to build the roads. And it is also easy to maintain them. So after the rain, if you see any pits, it is easily get repaired. It can be easily repaired. For example, after the heavy rain, the roads get damaged. So automatically, it can be easily repaired. But if you take mountains or hilly areas or the desert, what will happen? It is not easy. In the mountain areas, after the heavy rain, what will happen? Landslides will occur. And automatically, that region gets stuck. And no vehicles can move. Either they cannot come down or they cannot climb. They cannot go up. So we get stuck there. So all these are the advantages. But in case of plains, it is very, very easy to build the roads and maintain it. Okay. So even after the heavy rain also, if it gets damaged, it can be easily repaired. But in case of mountain region or desert, it is hard to construct the road. But with much more number of difficulties, roads have been constructed in the mountain regions as well as in the desert areas. At any time, there might be landslide in the mountain regions. Now think about the situation. Is it easy to repair the roads which is damaged due to the landslides? No. It is very, very difficult. Above all, it might lead to traffic. No vehicles can move from top to down or down to the top of the hill. So next, take the desert. You know about the formation of the sand dunes. If there is heavy wind blowing, it leads to the formation of the sand dunes here and there. So finally, what will happen to the railway tracks? It will be covered with the sand dunes, which is danger for traveling. So understood. So it is very easy to construct the roads in the plains, but it is not easy. It is very, very tough to construct the roads in the hilly regions like mountains and in the desert areas. So these roadways acts as a link between the cities and the towns. Now you know how the villages are connected to the district roads and how the district roads in turn connected with the highways within the state and then with the national, that is the border between the two states. So these are called as the national highways. So these roadways acts as a link between the cities and the towns in delivering the goods at the doorstep. So important facts related to goods, I think so only 1 minute is there. So can we end up the session with this? So tomorrow we'll continue, okay?